Good morning, children. Welcome to today's section. Children, in our last lecture video, we were covered the different types of operator: arithmetic operators, logical operators, relational operators, bitwise operators, and identity operators. All these types of operators we were covered in our last videos. So today, we can discuss the operator precedence and operator associativity. Okay. So first one, operator precedence. See children, when an expression or statement involves multiple operators, okay, then the operator will execute in a specific way. Okay, which operator will work at first or which operator will evaluate at first? This chart shows this operator precedence from highest to lowest. So the highest precedence for this parenthesis, okay. So the first one is parenthesis, second one exponent, third one bitwise complement, then positive or negative arithmetic operator. See here, star, slash, double slash, mod, okay. That is division, floor division, mod, okay. This one is all are having the same type of precedence, okay. Then addition and subtraction have same precedence, bitwise and bitwise XOR, bitwise OR, then comparison and identity. All these operators have same precedence and all are read from left to right. Then Boolean NOT, Boolean and Boolean OR. So this is the operator precedence chart for all the operators. Then next one is operator associativity. Okay, see, it is the order. Associativity is the order in which an expression having multiple operators of same precedence is evaluated. Okay, then all operators are left associative exponent except exponentiation. Exponent have right to left. Exponent will read from right to left. All other operators will read from left to right. Okay, then see here one example, 8 star 9, then division 11, floor division 12, okay, sorry, 2. So it will, all the operators have same precedence, that's why it will read from left to right. So it will do 8 star 9 at first, 8 9 star 72, then 72 will, divided by 11 will give 6.6, okay, then divided by 2 will give the answer 3.0. Okay, it will take only integer part, not decimal part, fractional part. See here next example. Here you can see the parenthesis. Parenthesis has the high precedence. That's why this parenthesis, which are given in the parenthesis, that will evaluate at first. So first, 8 star 9 will do. So 8 9s are 72, 72 divided by 11 will give 6.6, then double division, floor division by 2 will again will give the answer 3.0. But see a third example, here the parenthesis is given only for these numbers. So it will evaluate at first. So 9 divided by 11, so it will give the answer 0, then 0 floor division 2 will again see. Give 0, 0 into 8 will give the answer 0. Here 40 divided by 11, floor divided by 2. Okay, these two are separately grouped. So this one will evaluate at first. So 11 by 2, floor division. Okay, this will give the answer 5. Then 40 divided by 5 is equal to 8. Then 8 8s are 64. So we get the answer 64. Okay, so the for the associativity of operator, the operators will read from left to right except exponentiation. Okay, now let us check how the exponent operator will work. See here, 3 double star, 4 double star, 2. The double star for the power, 4 double star, 2 will give the power 2, that is 4 to the power 2, 4 square will give the answer 16. Okay, so when you write an expression like this, instead of doing 3 double star 4 double star 2, it will do 4 double star 2 at first, then it will do 3 double star 16. Okay, see here, for this expression, first it will work 4 double star 2. Okay, that is 16, then 3 double star 16, that is 3 to the power 16. So you will get this output. Then for next one here, you can see one parenthesis. So the parenthesis has the high precedence, that's why this will work at first. So first do 4 to the power 2, then 3 to the power 16. So you will get the same output. Okay. Then here, parenthesis is applied here. That's why 3 raised to 4 will work at first. Then only it will do this one. That is 3 raised to 4 will work at first. That's to the power 2. Okay. So you will get this answer. Okay. So the exponent has the associativity from right to left. All other operators will read from left to right. Exponent will read from right to left. Okay. So next one, expression. Children, we have already discussed this expression in our Python fundamentals. So we have an expression that is a combination of operators, literals and variables. Okay. So expression in Python can be of arithmetic expression, string expression, relational expression, logical expressions and compound expressions. Okay. So the first one, arithmetic expression. See here, example for arithmetic expressions are here 10 plus 20, here 30 mod 10. These are the examples for arithmetic expression. Okay. A group of variables are combined by operators, literals and variables. It's a combination of operators, literals and variables. The next one, relational expression. The relational operators are less than equal to, greater than equal to, not equal to and equivalent to. So, here you can see, here we have two operand and one operator. So, these are the examples for relational expression. Next one, logical expression. Okay, logical and, logical or and logical not. Three types of operators. So here, A or B, not A and not B, X greater than Y and Y greater than Z. So this is a combination of variables, logical operators and relational operators. Next one, string expression. Okay, string expression here, Python plus programming. Okay, so here both the variables are strings. Okay, the plus symbol will concatenate these two strings. Okay, it will join these two strings. That's why it will give the answer Python programming. Here, Python star 3. What's its meaning? See here, which number is given here, that much times this word will repeat. That is the meaning of this expression. So here, Python, Python, Python. So this word is repeated 3 times. Next one, how to evaluate these expressions. So first one, arithmetic. So the arithmetic expression executed based on the operator precedence and associativity. The operator precedence and also the associativity we were just discussed now. Then the implicit conversion takes place if mixer time is used in expression. Okay. Now what is mean by this implicit type conversion? See children, when you use mixer type of variables in your expression, that is integer type, string type, okay, or the integer type and floating points you combine together, then the Python implicitly convert the answer into the largest data type. Okay, the floating point is the largest one. That's why it will convert the answer into the floating point. So, an implicit conversion is a conversion performed by the interpreter without programmer's intervention. It is applied generally whenever different types are intermixed in an expression so as not to lose information. Okay, the rule is very simple. Python converts all operands up to the type of the largest operand, that is the type promotion. Okay, from the given set of variables, which variables has the highest byte, okay, or which is the highest data type, then all other will be converted into that type. Clear? Then, if both arguments are standard numeric type, then which are the rules? See, if either argument is a complex number, the other is converted to complex. Okay, when you give some variables in an expression, any of the argument is complex, then the other will be automatically converted into complex number. Then second one, if either an argument is a floating point number, the other is converted to floating point. Then third one, no conversion if both operand are integers, then no need of conversions. Okay, this one is called implicit conversion. This one is done by Python interpreter. Okay, so example here, n1 is equal to 10, n2 is equal to 5, then n4 is equal to 10.0, n5 is equal to 41.0, then n1 plus n2 divided by n4. So first we'll do 10 plus 5, 15, 15 by n4. Here n4 is floating point number, that's why you will get your answer as floating point. See here, b is equal to, here print a will give the answer 1.5. Okay, because 10 plus 5, 15, 15 by 10, n4 is 10. Okay, that's why you will get 1.5. Then for b, n5 by n4 into n1 by 2. Here the value of n5 is 41.0, n4 is 10.0, n1 is 10 and divided by 2. So, what output you will get? 20.5, because these two are integers and these two are floating point, that's why it will convert the answer into floating point. Okay, so here a comma b is equal to 10 comma 5. Okay, c equal to b by a, then what will be the output? Here b is equal to 5 and a is equal to 10. Okay, so b by a will give which one? 5 by 10. So the 0 point, you will get the answer 0 point, this symbol. Okay, see, the division symbol always return a floating point. Here, a comma b is equal to 10 by 5. B divided by floor division by a. Okay, so it will give the answer 2. Okay, 2 5s are 10. Floor division, not floor division, it will give the answer remainder. Instead of giving quotient, it will give remainder. Okay. So here, evaluating expression, that is a relational expression. How to execute? The executor based on the operator precedence and associativity. Then all relational expression yield Boolean value true and false. Therefore, chain comparison like -6 less than y less than z is equivalent to x less than y and y less than z. Okay, this is chain comparison. This we were already discussed in our last class. Now here we can check the output. See children, the last example here, c is equal to b, floor a will give the answer which one? 10 by 5. 10 floor 5 will give the answer 2. Okay, see here, some relational operators we can discuss. So, ABC is equal to 10D, 42, 42. Say multiple variable declaration. So, A is equal to 20, B is equal to 42, C is equal to 42. Okay, here, 42, 20, 20. Okay, then you can here print A less than B, print B less than equal to C, then print A greater than B less than equal to C. So this relation operators or the relation expression always give the answer either true or false. So first one, print A less than B. Here A is equal to 20 and B is equal to 42. Then A less than B will give 20 less than 42. So it will give the answer true. Like that you will get the answers for these two expressions. See the last one is a chain expression. Here it will evaluate by AND operation. So first you do A greater than B and B less than equal to C. Okay. Then next one. Logical. How to evaluate logical expression. Okay. Logical expression will evaluate in the order of NOT and O. Okay. It has precedence by itself, that is NOT and O. So the logical operators are short circuit operators. See here. 10 less than 20 and 20 less than 10 or 5 less than 7 and not 7 less than 10 and 6 less than 7 less than 8. It's a chain operation, chain statement. Okay, all the operators, that is logical operators, then the arithmetic operators parentheses is included, then the relational operators less than greater than that symbol is included in this example. Okay, so remember one thing, the logical operator will work NOT and O. So children, so now I believe you all understood all these operators. So anyone have any doubts, clear your doubts in the live section. Then on next section, we can discuss the typecasting. Okay, how to do typecasting and the standard library modules we can discuss in our next section. Then see you again with our new topic. Till then, bye. Thank you.